Hello and welcome to Kraaft It Live. I am your host, Heather Crafter, and I'm here with Debbie Davis, and we are going to have a blast. Welcome, everybody. I just want to say hi, and how are you? How are things going? I hope things are going crafty, because that's what we're all about here. So, Debbie, do you want to say hi?
I do want to say hi, and I just want to tell you guys that I am so proud of my crafting room. I got to show it off to some people who came in town from Google Plus. I mean, you know, Googlers, and they looked at my craft room and they said, "Wow, you're really good." I'm hearing something in the background.
Oh, did you start the? I don't hear it, so you can pretend that that
good
didn't
deal.
Happen.
Anyways, get on with the show.
So your craft room. I've had the pleasure of an honor of being actually in your craft room and getting to craft there, and I would say, yeah, you are really good. You've got great organization and a huge space to work on, so it's awesome. So there are some awesome people already in the audience, and I just was going to go through the list real quick, if you don't mind that. I want to say hi to Michael Daniels. Hi to Tim Longwell. Very glad to see you here, Tim. And Nanette, Sylvia, Tina, Beth, and Michelle. So hello, everybody. I just wanted to say hi, and I'm going to turn my phone off now because I forgot to do that. So here's what we're going to do. I'm going to transition over to the overhead camera, and we're just going to get straight to crafting because we've eliminated the ability to just sit here and chat, you know, and waste all that time in the beginning of the show. Why? Because of my Monday meanderings. And if you missed it, you can go up to Monday meanderings tab at the top of the page that you're on right now. Don't click on it yet. Save it for later. But go check it out, and you can see what we meandered about yesterday. So I think a winner was announced for our Craft Shack drawing for the month. Might want to go check it out. So I'm going to switch on over to my camera. This is my overhead camera while I'm switching the camera views here so we can chat and craft together. And in the meantime, Debbie, guess what?
What?
I've got this really cool feature I want to show to everybody. So are you ready to be on screen?
I am ready to be on screen.
All right, here we go. Take a look, folks. What do you think of this? Is this special or what? Now look, here I am, and there's Debbie. Where's Debbie? Over there. There's Debbie, and here's the workstation. What do you think? Let us know what you think. If you like how this view is, and if not, then we'll change it because, of course, this show is all about you guys. But so last week, oh, before we get started, do we have any comments we wanted to bring up on screen?
You know what? We have several comments we want to bring up on screen. So,
go ahead, because I'm getting ready while you do that.
All right. Well, you know what? Then let me just start out with the most important one, and that is, oh, and they're actually working today. Today's message brought to you by the one and only. Let faith and hope rule in your heart today. That one really, really speaks to me today because I am feeling extremely full in my heart, and it has a lot to do with faith. So then we have, whoops, oh, I just unclicked your next one. Sorry about that, Heather. We have, so do not throw away your confidence. It will be richly rewarded. Hebrews 10:35. Thanks, Heather, for bringing that up for us. That's really,
you're welcome.
Really wonderful.
Thank you for sharing that with everybody. This is something that has new to the Kraaft Shack that I'm sharing today's message, but I will tell you, I've been sharing this message secretly behind the scenes every single day since I've started this show. So now you all get to see it as a part of the show. Hopefully that's a good thing. Hopefully you're enjoying it, and hopefully you're ready to get crafting. Anything else?
Well, let me just do a quick roll call because we've got Michael, Tim, Nanette, Sylvia, Tina, Kathy, Beth, Maria, and Michelle all watching you, Heather. No pressure.
No pressure.
No pressure. And Michelle, it sounds like Michelle is going to be crafting along with you.
Awesome. What's she making?
She says, cutting all my stuff out on the Cricut, so I'm ready to craft along with the show. Need to clear some space. We know how that goes.
Yeah.
So she has room to work. Yeah, that's not that easy to do sometimes with all the stuff that we happen to have.
Okay, so I have got with me some stencils, and let's see, I just want to make sure that I get, can we get those to come off, or is that going to stay on there?
Well,
it seems like it's staying. Okay.
Yeah, it's uneyeballed, but
there you are. Okay, so it's just taking a second. Okay, good. All right, so what I have here is the canvas that I had shown last week. Now, I didn't make this on screen. I made it ahead of time, but I wanted to show you that I had used jelly plate poles to create kind of a sky and a landscape look. And then I had told you about, this is just a recap for those who might have missed last week or don't remember. I had created the rose with all the paper pieces that we put together. And then I took a jelly plate. This was, I think, done in the After Crafter party. I took one of the jelly plate poles and put it on a piece of watercolor paper and then created some grounding. And my first initial thought was to put these together on here. But now that I've had some time to think about it, I've made some changes in my head as to how this is going to go. So I think this is going to be an extra piece of art. So this is going to be a part of this canvas.
Can we just hang on one second, Heather? Mm-hmm. It appears that they can't see you. It says we can't see Heather for some reason.
Oh, that's hilarious. Okay, so guess what I need to do?
What do you need to do?
Oh, no, I don't know. Did that make any difference?
Let's see. Everyone's yelling, "We want Heather! We want Heather!" I don't know. So
How about you do me a favor? I'm going to switch over to just the overhead camera, and you go out and check the YouTube channel.
I will certainly do that. Video.
So I'll just switch to this one. We won't do anything fancy.
All right. Just trying out a little technology. And thank you, crafters, for the instant feedback during the live show.
Yeah, we like that. Except now I can't get it to go. I'm getting messages on my phone that I shut off, by the way.
All right, and as soon as everything is going well, somebody give us a message here. I see everybody typing stuff in. She's back.
I can't get it to switch the overhead camera.
Did
it on its own. Okay, well, you gotta love technology, folks. Isn't that the way we run around here?
Yes, it is.
So I'm going to check my phone because I've got a whole bunch of messages. All right, so I have no idea where to go back to, but the bottom line is this. I have created this piece last week, and it was jelly plate poles that I created to piece together, I should say, and then, of course, the rose that we made. And I had made this piece. I'm assuming everybody can see it now. No, because it still has my image, doesn't it?
Yeah, and I am looking over at YouTube, and boy, everyone's getting a chance to see me today. I'm so glad that I combed my hair.
It is a good thing you were ready to be on screen, because apparently I gave you all the screen time, which, you know, if you're going to choose something beautiful, right? Okay, so...
Oh, you're so sweet. Okay, yeah, all right, fine.
So the bottom line, people, is that I've decided not to use this. We're going to go with this. We're going to use this, and we're going to add some other stuff like this, okay?
And they can't see any of that. Oh, my gosh. It's not showing up at all, Heather.
Not at all? Not even this, what I just did?
No.
That's weird, because we can see it in ours, right?
Yep. I can see you are on the big camera. Yep, you're moving your fingers. I'm watching you, but nobody else can.
All right, let's... try that.
As if I were blue boxed.
Well, let's try this. I've clicked another button and we'll see if this makes any difference.
Okay. We will see, Sylvia.
Monday meanderings, the whole reason why I came up with Monday meanderings was to take away the yakety yak that happens at the beginning of the show so we could get just straight to crafting, because the first 10 minutes of blah, blah, blah is kind of boring. So now here we are at 9 minutes after, and we are still not crafting. So that worked.
Nope. That's not working. And it's just me, boy. They're just watching me. As if it hasn't switched over to your camera at all.
Not even now, huh?
Nope. And I can see you fine in the interface. Oh, all right. All right. Looking like over on YouTube, it came in.
Okay, so at this point, I may have actually clicked the correct button.
Alrighty.
I will take full responsibility for this because guess what, everybody? It's my show. So. Hey, welcome to Kraaft It Live, folks. In case you're just joining us, Kraaft It Live is a live crafting show where fun is to be had and, you know, mistakes are bound to happen, even technical mistakes. So, like I was saying, we are going to be using this canvas that I created and this cutout rose that I made last week. You watched me cut paper and glue stuff, and then I made this in the After Crafter Party, I believe, and I decided that originally it was going to look like this, and I decided to change my mind, and we're not going to go with that. Okay, you are now all caught up. Except I'm still getting messages, so let's make sure. Yes, you got it, finally. Thank you, Michael. I appreciate it.
Yeah, and then there's just one more, and I don't know. Maria is saying, why is the chat taking up half of the window?
I don't know. Because of your resolution on your computer, I think.
Oh, so yes.
Sometimes you have to change the resolution of your
computer. Okay. All right, get to crafting, will you?
Yes, ma'am. Okay, so I have some gloss gel medium, and we're going to be doing a whole lot of things that require drying time. So drying time is what I meant to say. So what I'm going to do is just get straight to this, and I've got this great stencil by Prima. It's part of the Finnebert collection, and I'm just going to put some gloss gel medium over it. It's very thick stuff. I love this. And you saw me use this at the beginning of the month when we were talking about our Crafters Challenge and how it dried to this pretty glossy sheen. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to do the same thing on here because it's going to add some dimension to this and just another one of those little hidden surprises as you twist the canvas around or that kind of thing. And never forget the sides. So what I'm going to do is pick it up carefully. And then I'm going to kind of tip it up, and I can actually see on my stencil where I haven't used yet, and so I can see that I just need to set it down like that and add a little bit more. Not sure if you can see that with the glare, but it's there, I promise. Just a tiny bit. Using my palette knife, kind of go over it. And there is, and this will dry clear because it's gel, so it will dry clear, and it will be very shiny because it's gloss. And I think I'm going to put just a tiny bit over here on this corner because I had some on the knife. No reason, no other reason. Okay, so there it is. So there's what's going to... Oh, I had it upside down, which is cool. It kind of gave it a different effect. That's kind of cool. So, yeah, that was totally on purpose. Mm-hmm. all right, just going to scrape off some of that extra and put some right there. That looks good. And I need to wipe this off. So here's the thing about this gel medium. You need to wipe this stuff off pretty quickly because it does dry fast and it will clog up your stencil. And one thing that I did learn by watching some videos over the past couple of weeks is to have, if you don't have a sink handy, which most of you who have watched my shows know that I don't have a sink down here in the craft shack, but if you take like a plastic tub and put some warm water in it, you could actually put your stencils in that and then wash them later. So that was part of my plan, but I don't know about you and plans, but me lately, they don't seem to be working too well. Clean off my palette knife so it's good to go for the next time we play around. And I am going to actually add a couple of more. I've got this dragonfly stencil, and you can see that I didn't clean that off very well, but I don't really care because it's going to add to this. So I'm going to take some coarse texture gel this time. So hopefully, if this works out right, that color that's on there just might mix a little bit and add to the fun. And I want to put some of these dragonflies up in the sky. And this coarse texture gel is kind of similar to like sand when it's dry. And again, because it's gel, it'll be somewhat transparent when it dries, too. So can you see that?
Oh, yeah. You know what? Dragonflies are some of Andrew's favorites.
I know, and I kind of thought he's going to like this. He usually does. So now I'm just cleaning. Can you see this over here, what I'm doing? I want to make sure I'm on camera still. Okay, so I'm just going to clean it off by scraping that up. And then I'm going to a different dragonfly. And I want to make sure I don't put this stencil down in that wet area. I'm going to choose this dragonfly here, and I'm just going to add some over the top and a little bit more over the top. So this is basically one layer on top. So the first layer, of course, is the jelly plate poles, and now I'm going to add some texture, you know, by adding those little bits there and there. And we're going to let this dry, I think. Yeah. Okay, so I'm setting this aside to dry somewhat. Oh, except I forgot one more step, so let me grab something else. Well, after I clean this, because you know that's the rule. You got to clean this real quick or else you can't use it again. Do we have any comments while I fiddle around with trying to find myself here?
Well, other than the fact that Sherry who came in just as the good part of the show started, so welcome, Sherry. She loves dragonflies and butterflies, too. They really do add a lot to some work. And Victor is here from Ukraine.
Well, hello again, Victor. That's like... Victor's been here for every single show this month, so yeah. Thank you very much. We're glad to see you. I forgot that I wanted to do some on this as well, so we're going to add that same... We're going to do the same thing. Nothing new here. And I want this to go more like this.
Hey, Heather, you know what? I was kind of messing around trying to figure out a problem before. Did you mention who won and got announced in Monday Meanderings?
I did. So if you're wondering who won our Kraaft Shaak challenge, the Kraaft Shaak drawing for September, I did draw the winner yesterday in Monday Meanderings.
Yay. Okay, so that's over on the website. Cool. I'm going to go.
It is.
I've been sort of distracted, so I'm catching up.
Oh, yeah, sort of distracted. You know what she means by that, folks? She's been having a really good time meeting actual people in real life that she... Some of you didn't even know, right, on Google Plus, but some you did?
Yeah, some I knew from Google Plus, but others were plusers that I had never met before. And we spent 4 days in what we're calling a hurl, hang out in real life. So I've been...
You know I don't like that term.
I know, but did you hear about the other term that they're thinking about using is HIP, which is hang out in person.
Yeah, and I like that term.
I
vote for HIP because I think it's hip to say HIP. Don't think it's hip to say hurl.
Yeah.
But that's just my opinion.
Yeah. So do you want to catch me up on what's going on in the community? Because I haven't had a chance, and I know
Holy
lots
smokes.
Has been going on.
I don't
on.
Know that I could catch you up, because the community has been a buzz. Okay, first of all, they are some sort of a, and somebody who participates in this is going to clarify it, I hope, some sort of a face drawing challenge going on over there.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So if you've not yet tried to draw faces, you might want to check that out. Maybe somebody can put the link where they were discussing it.
That sounds cool.
Sylvia, hint, yeah. Sylvia.
And is Sandra Artfully Made leading that up? You know what? She's not in the audience right now. So, she's over on YouTube.
Here's what I'll tell you what Sandra's doing. Sandra's visiting family. And she's been carving stamps and getting me all excited about carving stamps. And so this month I actually did, you saw the coffee stamp that I carved, right?
Yes, that was beautiful.
So I have carved some stuff. I know other people have started carving. I think Dawn had actually carved something with the bargain that she got. She's getting this stuff for like nothing. Cheap.
Really?
Yeah. All kinds of stuff happening over there about that.
Cool.
Okay. The next thing, this is really exciting, you guys. I'm going to put gesso on my cardboard. Are you ready for this? Okay.
Drum roll, please.
I know. That was me being sarcastic. Poorly being sarcastic. the thing of it is, I want to use this cardboard. And what I've done is I've taken two backs to my pads of paper. It's just the backing of it. And then I glued them both together. So what you see here is actually two, and it's going to make a very sturdy back board for the cross. Remember the cross that we made? So we're working on 3 pieces of art today. So that's what we're going to do with it. And it needs to be gessoed first. Do you have more comments to bring up on screen?
I do.
Are they just chatting with themselves? Because that's
cool. Oh, well, there is some chatting, and Maria is kind of fighting with the window not being big enough, and the chat seems to be taking over, but she's dealing with that. So thanks, Maria, for being resourceful on that. Did we mention that Sylvia says tweet is done?
Oh,
so
the tweet.
Over at the Kraaft, if you're over on Twitter, at KraaftCheck is the Twitter handle.
And there's actually a tweet this. There's a tweet this little birdie on the webpage right now, somewhere around where you're watching this screen.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Okay. I'm like growing up. You'd be so proud of me.
I got to get over there. Okay. And then Sylvia also says, yes, gel medium is a very slow drying paint that is used to make the dry time longer. I didn't know that.
Mm-hmm.
And you can mix it with paint to make the dry time longer, or use it as Heather did to add some clear dimension to paper. Thanks, Sylvia. She's got some good pointers.
So I am spreading this real loosely because what I want for this gesso to do is just create a background to grab onto. We're going to add some color and whatnot. And you can actually add your color to gesso if you wanted to, but I don't want to. It waters it down some. Not waters it down, that's not the right word. It mutes the color some. So if you have like a real vibrant pink, it'll be more of a muted pink because the white will change the hue.
And yes, there's lots of conversation going over on the live. If you're watching this on YouTube, we have a conversation going on that you can enter through the website. That's Kraaft Check website, Watch It Live tab. And we have a live conversation going on with our crafters. So, like I said, if you're watching this on YouTube right now, live, then you can join our conversation by going to our website and then clicking in to the live conversation. If you're watching this as a replay, well,
you can actually join the conversation as well.
That's right. You can still go in to the Watch It Live tab on KraaftCheck.com and see the conversation.
Yeah, and actually, once the show is over, I move it to what is called the Video Treasure Chest. And you can watch it there, and you can actually comment and interact. So if you missed last week's show and you're wondering how we made that awesome rose, you can go watch all the excitement of me cutting and gluing. I'm telling you, man, it was super exciting, right?
It was super exciting. If you like watching cutting and gluing.
Yeah, if you like that. Okay, guess what I did? I forgot a couple of items. Shocking, shocking.
What do you mean?
Well, I forgot paint for one thing.
Oh.
And I have to go grab that, and which means I need to take the headset off or else I get into pain.
Yeah, because we know what happens. Go ahead, go get it.
All right, so you do your thing. I'll be right back.
I'll do my thing. Yeah, cuz Heather's kind of tethered. Heather is tethered by her headset, and if she walks away, and sometimes she does, she'll walk away with it on and then you hear her yell because it hurts. So we'll let her walk away for a minute. So it's good to see everybody. Let me see who else, if there's anyone new in since I yelled out the roll call. We've got a nice full room. And Michael, you know what? I started to type you a comment. You're watching. If there's anything you can do to help Maria, I'm not really sure what the problem is that's causing her window to be out of proportion, but if you guys could read each other's comments, and Michael, any suggestions would be greatly appreciated.
Still having issues with the window.
Huh? She's just going to leave it for now, but I just thought that maybe...
Yeah, we don't want anybody to have a bad experience, so we really do appreciate you letting us know, and we'll do all we can to make it better.
And I'm looking over at YouTube again, and the camera is on me again.
Well, only for that second while I went and got the... It's back, I promise.
Oh, okay.
No, I lied. I promised and I lied. I apologize. Okay, back to normal.
Back to normal.
Okay, so this is still a little wet, which is totally fine because I don't think it's going to harm the process at all. So I've got this really cool, everybody's seen this, I think. It's another Prima stencil, which I love, and it looks like cracks in the wall or something. And I want to do something different. I've never done this before, so we're going to see how this goes. It's still a little damp, and I'm okay with that because I think I want it to grab. And I've got a distress stain, which is called Spiced Marmalade. And since it has a dauber on the top, we're just going to go for it and see what happens.
I love this stencil.
I actually do, too, and I didn't, when I first got it, I thought, oh, well, it was, I think, on clearance. Sorry if that's loud in your ear, by the way. But
no, go ahead.
I think it was on clearance when I grabbed it or on a sale or something, and I thought, nah, this isn't something I would normally get. I've used this probably more than any other stencil I own now. All right, I'm going to do this in different spots. I don't think I want the whole thing. I think I want it to just kind of come through in just different areas.
And Susan R., by the way, just entered the room, too. So hello, Susan.
Hi, Susan. Haven't seen you in a little while. It's been at least a week. You know, I miss you all so much. I really do. If I had my way, I was telling this to Debbie in the green room, if I had my way, I would just quit everything else and only do the show. Because I like hanging out with you guys, and I like getting messy. And honestly, I'm gonna admit something here. I have not been in the craft room since last Tuesday. I actually had to clean up last Tuesday's mess in order to get in here and start today's show. That's how long it's been, and that's very frustrating to me. You know what's really cool? Oh, I got something else to share. Okay,
what?
I'm doing a different color now, aged mahogany. So these wonderful people that we know as crafters in our community have been doing something really cool. Many of them have been taking part in that creative blog hop that I was invited to. They've started doing it and carried on the torch, as it were. And several new posts are up as of yesterday. And you can meet some new crafters this way. And some of them, they're real artists. It's really cool to see what some of the people have come up with and what they're sharing and getting to know them better. I'm loving it. But that's something you've missed out on, Debbie. You need to go check it out.
And if I wanted to check that out, I would just go over to Crafters, the Google Plus Crafters community. Are you guys talking about it over there?
Yeah, type in Creative Blog Hop in the search box, and I guarantee you'll find something.
In the search box in the community. Boy,
yeah.
I love the search function in the communities. Creative Blog Hop. Okay, good.
For sure. You nailed it. So this one is called Frayed Burlap. That should be good, right?
Mm-hmm.
Who knows what this is going to be like when it's all said and done. It might not even look like cracks, but, you know, this is part of the adventure. I don't know if using stain, see, like right there, it just bled through. I know for a fact that's not going to look very good, but it's just one layer on my thing, so I don't care. Oh, and I forgot to mention this, too, at the very beginning of the show. I will not be able to attend After Crafter Party today. We have dentist appointments to go to. If you can imagine, that's what I have to go do with my free time.
Not fun.
Yeah. So I'm sorry, because you know how much I love the After Crafter Party, and I don't get to partake, so that kind of bums me out a little bit. Well, a lot, actually. All right, I'm going to take a piece of paper. Let's grab this watercolor paper that's right here. I just have a big piece of watercolor paper. I'm going to put it over the top of this to soak up all of that stain. Trying not to put it into the stuff that I've got laying here drying. So let's just see what happens.
What kind of paper are you using right now?
It's watercolor.
Watercolor, okay.
And I'm going to flip it and get this other side over here. It's not really like absorbing anything. I kind of thought that this would be better than any other paper because it's not really absorbing it much.
Yeah. Interesting.
Mm-hmm. When in doubt, grab the paper towels. All right. And here's what it looks like underneath.
It looks like feathery.
Yeah, it's kind of different. All right, I'm just going to keep on trucking down this way a little bit further and do the same thing. And I'm going to go over the same areas with the same color, just so that way I don't make any mud. That's my thinking. It's actually a pretty quick way to do a background, and it's a very different result than what I anticipated, but it's still pretty cool. Oh, there's some right there.
Yeah, and let me just pull up Beth's comment here. She says, I had trouble getting the paint through the small cracks, and once it did, it was messy looking rather than crisp.
Yeah, it's not crisp, and that it's certainly not going to be with the distress stain, that's for sure. But, you know, it worked really good with, like, the modeling paste that I did on the triptych, if anybody saw that episode. I liked the result it gave me there. But I like this result, too, because I was really just trying to experiment with color and adding color to it. And I will say I did just realize something.
What's that?
By putting it down on the wet gesso, it kind of stuck to the stencil a little bit on the underside. The gesso did.
Right.
So I pulled that off a little when I pulled off the stencil. So you can kind of see here. But that's going to add to the distress look. So I'm not really upset about it. I just wanted you to be aware that's what happened by not waiting for the gesso to dry completely before I put this down. So that's kind of fun. Ooh.
That is really cool. I like the colors. I like the way the colors are coming in.
Yeah, and because this is the underside, this part is the underside, I'm going to flip it over and just add it to the watercolor paper, and I'm going to set this aside to figure that out later. Look at this paper towel. Ooh.
Oh, you know, that's got Sylvia really, really wanting it.
Yeah, and I'm thinking, do I want to dab? Yeah, I'm going to dab. Yeah. Why not? Ooh, that's kind of cool. I like this.
That makes me want to take out a fine point micron and doodle.
I know. That's a great background for that. But that's not my goal. So I'm going to grab another stencil and a different medium. So that was, and basically this whole month we've been talking about mixed media. And we've been stretching our limits, basically. That was what the whole challenge was about, was stretching ourselves outside of the boxes we put ourselves into. And I've got another stencil. This one is a Tim Holtz stencil. And what I really wanted to do was be able to... It's like sunburst rays or something. And I want to be able to add those so that they peek behind the cross. We're going to see what that looks like when I'm done, I guess. Wish me luck. Okay. All right, so I have some modeling paste, I think. I want to use that. Oh, I can't decide if I want to use that or the gloss medium because, one, I don't have very much of my modeling paste left. This I'm trying to use up this cheap thing, and it's turned out I like this the most. And now I don't have much of it left. So we're going to go with the gloss, which is not that one. This is the gloss.
Okay. And the gloss will dry clear, yes?
Yes. So we're just going to pile some of that. I love this stuff because look at how thick that is. I mean, it's holding its shape and everything.
Yeah.
And this is really inexpensive. What did we buy these for at Michael's? It was like $3.
I think they had a sale on, so we could get three for $10 or...
Something like that. Yeah, I think you're right.
You just reminded me. I bought some loot that day, and I have not had a chance yet to play with any of that.
Darn work gets in the way of having fun sometimes. That's why you should just have a job where this is what you do for your living.
So. Okay, all right. I'm quitting my other one.
I think that's a good idea. I'm just saying. Okay, so I'm going to leave. This is going to be kind of like a hidden surprise underneath that, except I'm going to do something different with this one. And I'm going to need to use the heat tool. So if there's something that you wanted to screen share or some comments you wanted to run through, be prepared real soon because I'm going to lift this off, and I don't know if you can see that.
Just barely.
I'm cleaning the stencil really fast here.
Okay, because I'm watching over on YouTube too, where I it seems to always be a clearer picture on the recorded version. So,
all right. Okay, so here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to grab some embossing powder, and I think I'm going to grab gold. Oh, do I want gold?
I think gold would be kind of cool. I don't know.
I'm going to mix. I have this silver pearl, and I have this gold. I'm going to use them both. Okay, so here it is. Can you see that shiny? Wait, let me grab it. Shiny. There's the shiny. The shiny rays sticking out. Okay, then I'm going to take the clear embossing. I'm just going to try, or this isn't clear, this is gold. And I'm going to try and add it to the center where basically the sun would be. And I've done this before and regretted it, so we'll see how this goes. Piece of paper towel on my surface. And just kind of bounce it off of there. Now remember, it's still kind of wet from the stain and all that other stuff, but I don't care. Oh, that's awesome. Okay.
That is cool looking. And there's a lot of conversation going on about the crackle, about using a crackle paint. So people are sharing their ideas about, you know, just getting an effect similar to what you might expect from the crackle stencil.
Yeah, and you know, crackle paint is really cool, but you know what? I did an entire show on using white Elmer's glue under acrylic paint and got the same crackle effect.
Really?
Yeah, it's really inexpensive to do it that way. It was lots of fun. Maybe we should do that again.
That's cool.
There's that. And the shimmer shine is kind of gone, but we're going to bring it back. So here I'm going to mute myself, and you can do some screen sharing or comments. What do you want to do?
Excellent. I will do some comments. I'm going to just bring some up here real quickly. And let's see. Beth is telling us that she uses gel mediums as glue as well. And that, there was another one here from, oh yeah, Sherry. She tweeted and she posted on her business page as well. So thank you, Sherry. You know what? We really appreciate it when you guys do some of the sharing. Sherry shared. When you do some of the sharing and that sort of thing, let other people know what's going on over here at the Kraaft Shaak, because, you know, we do have a whole lot going on. And then I think this is from Sherry as well. If you guys know who Julia is with Stamping Ground, W-O-Y-W-W Wednesdays, you'll have to explain that to me. She participated yesterday as my invitee. Sherry, that sounds really cool. I know you guys have a lot going on over in the community talking about the blogging and the blog hop. All that stuff. So I really need to get caught up. Again, Crafters Community is a Google Plus community for those watching on YouTube, and there is a link in the YouTube description. So join us over there, because that's how all of these ladies have, and gentlemen, I'm sorry. It is ladies and gentlemen in the Crafters Community, and we're all sharing tips and mostly posting pictures of, you know, photographs of the work that's been done. So it's just eye candy over there. You can go over there and go through all the pictures of what people are creating. A lot of it is inspired by what we do here on the weekly show too. So far, all that's been inspired for me is go out and shop and buy products. Now I need to get to work. So one of these days, I will do that. All right, we've still got some hot glue gunning going on. Not hot glue gunning. Heat tool stuff going on over there that we volume down for. And she said that she's going to bring some of the shiny back, and maybe that's part of this heat process right now where the shiny is going to start poking through as it dries. And then the cross will go over that, so you'll see those sun rays coming out from behind it. That's going to be a beautiful effect. Looking forward to see what she does with it from there. This is all on canvas, I think, right? I think she's got it on canvas. And the drying continues. Sorry, folks. Sometimes you just have, you know, this is like watching paint dry sometimes, right? Yeah. But that's okay. It'll be all worth it in the end, as it always is. Again, there is no after crafter today, because Heather gets to go to the dentist instead. So no after crafter party. But if she doesn't get to finish this, I know that she'll post it on the website as well as in the community as well. So we'll get to see how she finishes it off. All right, Heather, bring us back in. We want to see what you're doing. She's drawing. Very patiently, she's drawing. All right. Let me see what's going on over in the comments. Again, we have, if you go to craftcheck.com and click the Watch It Live tab, you can also participate in these comments. Woo! She's back.
Okay, can you see it now?
Mm-hmm. Yep, you can.
So now it's embossed, and that means that powder that we put on there has turned to like a hard enamel, and the ones that I chose happen to be silvery and gold. So hopefully you can see that.
That's really nice, yep.
It's kind of hard to see straight on. You have to look at it from an angle, it seems like, to really see.
Yeah, the light needs to reflect.
It would be really awesome if the background was more black or darker colors, probably. That might make a difference. But, okay, so here is the gist of what I wanted to go there, basically. And this is going to be put up on top with some cardboard. Where did the cardboard go? It's moved. So I was going to put cardboard on the back of this to give it some lift, so you can imagine that.
Oh, yep.
But before I do that, I wanted to do some decorating of it. So you said so?
Well, I was asked, is that canvas? Tell me again. You know what? I've got my mind going in a million different directions. Are you working on canvas right now where you put the crackle stencil?
This was cardboard backing from the pads of papers that I use.
All right. Sherry was paying attention. That's what she said. Okay.
Yeah, and I glued two of them together using my Liquitex matte gel medium. Like, I think you said somebody uses it for glue.
Yep.
I didn't remember the name. I didn't hear it, actually. So, yeah, that's what I did. I used my matte gel to actually glue the two pieces of cardboard together to give a really firm background.
It's so funny. As you're telling me this, Sherry put it into the comments. Maria put it into the comments. They're hanging on every word, and I don't know what I'm doing over here.
Well, you're kind of busy. I mean, you're like, you know, going through comments and stuff, so I don't blame you. Okay, so now I've got what is this thing called? Gelato. And I'm just going to frame this out with the gelato and use my baby wipe to really just kind of blend it in. I don't really want to get rid of the color, so it's more a matter of just getting it wet, getting my finger wet. And then really blending it in. I wanted to be able to finish all three of these today, but those technical difficulties threw me for a loop.
9 minutes of technical difficulties at the beginning. Ugh.
Yeah, not cool. Not cool. it all well. And you know what's really good is that we have such great friends who are willing to hang out with us anyway. So that's
well. Nice. As a matter of fact, Susan just said too, because you know it was taking a long time for that to dry, and she said, "I enjoy watching the effect become evident on screen. Don't mind not much else happening." So thank you, Susan, for encouraging us.
Yeah, I appreciate that because sometimes, like last week's show was lame. I mean. Everybody was kind and wonderful with their comments and everything, but it really was lame to watch me just cut paper and glue stuff. Super exciting, I must say.
And you know what? When you're being lame, the people in the audience are being very entertaining, so I'm having a blast over here.
I know. And I go back and I read the comments, and I'm like, well, nobody seemed bored at all, so that's awesome. It seems boring to me, I guess, because I don't get to participate in the comments until after it's all over.
That's right, yep.
That's why I beg you to bring them on screen so I can pretend that I'm a part of the conversation a little.
Well, I'll try and keep you in the loop a little more then, Heather.
All right, thank you. Okay, so this is basically just a frame. That's what I wanted to do is frame this out. If you ever notice if your work seems to be missing something, chances are if you take like a darker color... I tend to use brown usually, but not in this particular piece. But if you frame it out with a darker color, it just finishes it. So right there we have, it's not like it just sort of goes off into space and doesn't end. It actually is framed, which helps tremendously. And there was some other things that I wanted to add to this, but I'm going to set it aside for a minute. Well, don't judge me on that minute because it might be longer than a minute.
Well, just no pressure, but you've only got 13 left, so.
Yeah, I know. So with this, what I wanted to do, and I'm just going to show you what I wanted to do with this. I've got a couple of markers, and I still forgot to go get that other marker. Dang it! I'd like to use my bigger marker. I can't remember what it's called now. The pit.
Uh-huh.
The Faber-Castell Big Brush Pit Artist Marker. That's what I want to use because it has a much bigger tip to it. But we'll use this. This will work. So now what I'm going to do is just pick out some things. Remember you mentioned doodling?
Yeah.
This particular piece, I want it to look very much mosaic. So I'm going to actually create my mosaic lines by kind of sort of following some of what I see. And then creating some of what I don't yet see. So here, obviously, this blue piece looks a lot like that. But then I think I'm going to actually create a smaller break in it. Here and here. So I just broke it up into three pieces rather than one large one. And then keep it kind of the same. And here I'm just following some of the. Is this too far away? Do I need to be closer in?
If you can bring it in a little closer, that would be kind of cool. We could experience it a little differently.
Yeah, see some of it.
And then bring your cross down. There you go. That's nice.
Okay, so what I did is just followed the natural line that was there, and then I followed the line that was in the art itself. So now I'm going to outline it. Again, really define those edges by outlining the piece. And you can imagine what it'll be like once I do the whole thing.
So while you're drawing a little bit, I just wanted to mention that this Thursday, one of the shows that I helped to produce, it's called the Plus Your Business Show, and we are featuring the Kraaft Shaak and Heather Crafter on that show. So maybe I'll drop a link into that event over in the community too for those who are in the community and want to see and hear what Heather has to say, because I got a feeling she's going to be giving a lot of kudos to the people that make this all go.
I love talking about my community. So I was really honored to be asked to be a part of that show because I get to chat some more about the wonderful people that I adore, and that's pretty much all of you crafters. So, yeah. Drop the link. That would be cool.
I will drop the link.
Thanks for mentioning that, Debbie. That's really sweet of you.
Well, thanks for she's going to make me look so good. I it was my job to bring in some guests, and yeah, she's going to make me look like a real smart person.
Well, that's no pressure. Okay, so I just cut I just trimmed off the edges there because they were kind of sticking out and being weird. So I wanted to be more precise, and you can see that better there. And I have to go over this one here again. And you get the idea, I hope. So if I were to keep going, it would look a lot like this. And I'm trying to purposefully do kind of rough edges because, you know, I don't know that I've never really done anything with mosaics, but when I admire mosaics, they don't seem to be perfect. Maybe that's why I like it so much. It just seems so very unperfect.
That looks very relaxing.
Yeah, this would be. I could actually finish the show doing this, but we have other things we need to finish. So you get the idea. I'm going to go around and do that with the whole thing. Looks
beautiful.
Pretty cool.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and then you can imagine that on the background we just created, raised up some. Oh, I got to zoom back out so that you can see that better. So raised up somewhat off of the canvas or the handmade canvas, I guess it would be. And you can kind of grasp what that'll be.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Yep.
So we'll set that one aside. I apologize that it wasn't finished on screen because that is what I was really hoping to be able to do. But, okay, so here you can kind of see how it's drying some.
Yep.
And you can kind of see the shine in there somewhere. If I could just grab it. Work with me, lights.
Yep,
there we go.
It's glittering a little bit.
Okay. And then this one, actually, this particular piece had some shimmer on it from what we did. So there's shimmer there, too. So that's kind of cool. And down here you can see some more. So the bottom line with this one is I wanted to have this rose that we created together. I wanted to have that. And then I wanted to also have words. So the words were a part of today's message. And I'm going to use this. Oh, and I also wanted to put some lace and stuff on there, but I can't really do that until it's totally dry. And let's see here. I needed a finer tipped marker. Let's use this Sharpie and see if it will cooperate with me. So the message, and here, let me just show you. This is where I get my messages from. I have one of those perpetual calendars that each day of the year it looks like this. I've been using this since the very first day of my show. So this thing has been with me the whole time. This and Kathy Gillette. So, and Sylvia. Sylvia's almost been there that long, too. So.
Yep, all right, that's right.
So basically, what I have here is let faith and hope rule in your heart today. And that is what I'm going to use on this piece of scrap paper as my words to add. And I think I'm going to do it just like this. So again, a very exciting moment where you get to see me write letters.
Well, what's kind of fun is you're freehanding this, which I don't even attempt.
Why wouldn't you attempt? You have beautiful handwriting. Why wouldn't you attempt it?
Because it's, you know, well, because you can misspell, so.
Oh, yeah, I've done that before. I was actually just recently watching a video where somebody had done that very thing, whatever.
That was so funny.
And I wasn't live on camera making that, so I can't even blame that. But anyway, so.
Let faith and hope.
Yeah, and I think I'm going to get creative with some of these letterings.
Like doodle letters?
A little bit. Not a lot, but a little bit.
What are you writing on?
It's just a piece of scrap cardstock or designer paper or something that was in my scrap bin. It looks very much like music paper.
Oh, that's okay. It was hard to tell what the design was.
Yeah.
And there she goes getting crazy creative.
All right, let faith and hope. And I'm going to change faith a little bit, but in a minute. Rule. In.
And then Beth Sin is asking, is the October challenge in the Monday meanderings? I'm sorry. And yes, that's exactly where it is, Beth. So go over to the website, craftcheck.com.
And can I ask for clarity first before you continue that?
Yes, you can.
Okay. She said, is the October challenge?
You're right.
Okay, so the October challenge is always, this is how we announce the monthly challenge, is each, the very first Tuesday of the month, we do a show and it's all about the challenge. So the first Tuesday of October, which is next Tuesday, will be all about October's challenge.
Got it. That's what she was asking, I'll bet.
You know what it is? I can hear it rather than see it. So I was able to.
Mm-hmm. And you know what? I'm feeling a little spacey today. Sorry.
I think you've just had a really awesome weekend.
Yeah, I have had an awesome weekend. A lot of eating, a little bit of drinking because we had some sponsors from distilleries and breweries and all, but unbelievable food because we had 3 chefs in our midst.
Yeah, no, that's pretty cool.
At this hurl, yeah. So lots of great cooking, and I didn't go to bed before 3 o'clock in the morning any night in the last 5 nights.
Aha.
So that's
That explains a little bit, I think.
That explains it. Let's see. Something here is Sylvia is saying, I don't think we're going to hear it today, Sherry. Let's see what it is that Sherry's looking for. Sherry says, maybe you'll know what's going on here, Heather.
Okay.
She says, Heather, you commented on my post earlier today that I needed to be watching today for what's coming in October.
Oh, that is right. I had almost forgotten.
Thank you, Sherry, for reminding her.
Yes, because I'm going to start something different tomorrow. Tomorrow's Wednesday. And I've had this idea to do something similar to this for a while, but it just didn't work. So tomorrow is what we're going to do. On Wednesdays in October, and who knows, this might be a thing that'll stick. I don't know. But on Wednesdays in October, I am going to put in the community a word. And if you choose to be inspired by that word, you can create anything you want. Basically, it's going to be word. It's the Wednesday's word, and that word is hopefully going to inspire you to create some kind of art. That's the bottom line. You choose what kind of art you're going to create, whether it's cards or scrapbooking or whatever it is that you're into, mixed media, I don't care. And then you're going to just post that on your blog or in the community or on your Facebook page, and you're just going to tell the world that you're participating in Wednesday's word at the Kraaft Shaak.
You know,
and we all
I
get to comment and have some really awesome fun with it, is my thinking. So we'll
I haven't heard you say this for a while, but I know that it's, I see it on the website, but you're helping us find our crafty bone.
Yeah, and that is the reason why I was getting back to it, because I have not really done much to inspire people to actually get out and craft. Well, that hasn't been my focus. And I realized last week when I was doing that show with Jason that I was talking a lot about, you know, prizes and giveaways, which I have done a lot of talk about, but I haven't really talked about what are you doing to just be inspired and get out there and create, and that's what I want to do with Wednesdays. So Wednesday's word hopefully will inspire you to get out and create. And you can look for it, be posted. It will be posted in the community. So if you're not a Crafters Community member, that's one more thing you're missing out on. And I got to tell you guys, I am not the star of that show. That show is all about crafters.
And the Crafters Community, there is a link right in the description of the YouTube channel if you're watching from there.
There should be, but I wouldn't guarantee it. But yeah, there should be. Make a note. Why don't you make a note? Because you're awesome like that.
Or get on Google Plus and search for Crafters Community, Kraafters Community, also spelled with a K.
And you know what you can do? You could probably put the link to it right here in this chat, unified chat box that we've got here. So
I think everyone here in the unified chat is a Crafters Community member.
Yeah, and we'll put that in there. So
yeah.
And if anybody has the ability to add the link, we'd appreciate it. All right. Here's the thing about cutting out these words. What in the world did I do? I cut them out, and now they're out of order, and now I have to put them back together like a puzzle.
So that means you have to remember.
Thankfully, I have it over here off camera. You can't see it, but it's right over there. So thankfully, I can figure it out.
Well, while you're figuring that out, I had brought up a comment from Sherry earlier, and she said something. I'm just going to pull it up here again real fast. If you guys know who Julia is with Stamping Ground at WOYWW Wednesdays, and then...
Oh, that has something to do with what's on your workstation or work desk or something like that.
There we go. What's on your work desk Wednesday? Sherry gave us that little piece of advice later. So thanks. See, they're just listening to me blab on.
Which is awesome. Awesome. I mean, that gives you purpose for blabbing, if you ask me.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I'm just going to glue these down with my Liquitex matte gel. And then, of course, once it's dry, I'll outline them with the marker, and I'll add some white paint. Something we haven't talked about in a while are some white paint markers. I like these painters' markers. I just got all of these. The Sharpie one is nice, too, but I got all of these at Walmart. So you know me and my Walmart. I always rummage through there to find what I can use. But I like using those. I know there's a really great pen, white pen by Signo, I think. But mine's dead, and I can't get a new one yet. So I'm
okay,
without.
And I want to thank Sherry and Michael for putting links in the comment stream here for the community. And then if you'll just, because I'm going to... have to warn you that you're 2 minutes over right now. Sorry about that. So
yeah,
let us know.
I don't care if you don't.
Let us know where we're going to see the finished piece.
Yeah, I'm trying to get to the point where we can at least say, okay, and when you see it again, it'll be finished with all that stuff, but I'm not there yet, I guess. Always, I will be posting a blog post this week for this particular... that's not where I want that to go. Hold on. I can't talk and do this at the same time.
Sorry.
Clearly...
Quiet on the set, please.
Crafter
trying to think.
Yeah, that's a scary thought all in itself. Okay. All right, so here we go. That's pretty much how I wanted that to go. And I need to glue down the rows and everything else. And basically what I'll do is I'll post some pictures. I will try to take some step-by-steps or maybe even do a quick video of the finished product. What do you think of that?
We love video.
I know. I actually like doing video more than I like taking pictures, so maybe that's what I'll do. But I have to do it after my dentist appointment. So that's what I'm going to do later today, you guys. And I will post the link, of course, in the Crafters Community, and you can always find it right here on craftshack.com. And if you're watching this on YouTube, the link to craftshack.com, where you can find everything that we do, and you can search for it if you're looking for something specific, is all right there in the description of this and every other video we do. So that's pretty much it. Oh, you know what I did want to say?
What?
Guess what I'm going to do with these pieces once they're all finished.
Tell me.
Okay, I am sending, and let me grab the other one. I'm sending all of these to my grandmother's church. All three of these are going to be sent to my grandmother's church, where they're going to hopefully someone will buy them, and all the money will go to their church. They are celebrating 50 years of being a church, really.
Wow.
And I actually, that's where I was confirmed. That's where I went since I was in kindergarten. I just love that. I taught VBS there. I love that church. So it's my way to give back. So that's it. I will now officially close the show.
It was good to see everybody.
It was very good to see everybody. Thank you all very much for joining us, and we look forward to your posts in Crafters Community. And if you're not a member, you know how to find it by now, I hope. So we'll talk to you later. Have a crafty day, everybody. Bye-bye.